To be
or not to be? That is the question. Whether it is nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of troubles and by opposing end them. To die, to sleep, no more. And by sleep to say we end the heartache and the thousand natural shocks that flesh is heir to. The consummation devoutly to be wished. To die. To sleep. To sleep. A chance to dream. Aye. There's the rub, for in that sleep of death, what dreams may come when we have shuffled off this mortal coil must give us pause. There's the respect that gives calamity a so long life. For who would bear the whips and scorns of time, the oppressor's wrong, the proud man's contumely, the pangs of despised love, the law's delay, the insolence of office, and the spurns that the patient merit of the unworthy takes, when he himself might make his quietus with a bare bodkin? Who would fathers bear to grunt and to sweat under a weary life, but that the dread of something after death, the undiscovered country from whose bourne no traveller returns, puzzles the will and makes us rather bear those ills we have than fly to others we know not of? Conscience makes cowards of us all, and thus the native hue of resolution is sicklied o'er with pale cast of thought, and enterprises of great pitch and moment with this regard their currents turn awry and lose the name of action.